Guys, today we are working on this beautiful 1985 Targa in Guards Red. And on the back side there, I'll show a little video. It's been repainted, so it's actually turned white. And the door looks a little bit more deep, rich red, but still, nonetheless, you can see it's got a lot of paint fade. So what we're going to talk about today is the difference between hand polishing versus machine polishing. A lot of people ask me about that. And the difference between, let's say, a clear-coated car over here versus one that is single stage, you might in fact be able to, and you can, hand polish a single stage paint. The difference is, with a machine, you'll be much faster. So my analogy would be, you can dig a hole with a 6-foot hole with a spoon. It is very possible to do that. It'll take you a long time, but you can do that. Or you can dig it with a backhoe, and it'll take you half the time and utilize the machine. So in this case, I'm gonna be using the Rube's polisher instead of a hand, but you can use hand polishing on single stage. You cannot on clear coat. It doesn't work like that. So anyways, we're gonna talk a little bit about that. I'll show you the tools, I'll show you techniques. Other thing we're gonna talk about again is residue control. This is dead skin on this car. So it's all this whiteness that you'll see, dead skin. So I have to remove that, and that by removing it, I gotta put it somewhere. So we're gonna use the pad washer and air and all the things that we've talked about in the past. And then there's a lot of trim on these older cars. And there is wax just build up everywhere. So we're gonna clean a lot of that out, and I'll show you some of the things that I do to preserve it. And the last little bit is these cars are going bananas. The values of specifically air-cooled Porsches going through the roof like crazy. So the interesting part about doing a restoration like this is I'm just gonna take a Honda Civic, let's say. If you were to restore that one and then go to sell it, yeah, you'd make some more money on a cleaner car versus a non-clean car. The ratio of doing a dirty car like this in an 85, then me restoring it, the value is actually pretty significant, a couple thousand dollars, based on the fact that the values overall are rising. Hopefully that makes sense. So this is a good investment for this particular owner. Anyways, without further ado, let's hop in and I'll show you a few things about the paint depth that I know it's been repainted. So I'll show you right now. Here's just a small example of what I'm talking about in terms of this area, as you can notice, is really, really white compared to this area. Now, this has been repainted, and it certainly looked that way from just, experience of looking at these cars. But I'm taking my Positector from Delfesco, putting it on there, and it's telling me it's about 8 mils. Now, if I come over to the door is about 4 mils, and around the rest of the car, it's about 4 to 5 mils, which is typical of these older Porsches. When it goes up to double the amount of mils, instantly in my mind, I say, hey, it's been repainted. So I check that box off, I think about it, and I say, there's more mils. So that's something to think about. And then the fact that this is degrading at a different rate than the factory paint also means to me somebody in some random body shop painted this single stage, and it didn't quite work out. So when I'm polishing this, by hand or by machine, but again, I'm doing it by machine, I have to factor these things in and think about it, because this may wear differently. I may burn through 2 or 3 mils really quickly, or maybe I won't. I don't know, but I know when I go onto this area, I gotta be on top of my game. Does that make sense? So I'm gonna work on the door first to see how the rest of the car is gonna work, and then hop on this and see what the difference is. So again, it's always kind of bobbing and weaving and letting the paint tell you what it wants. So let's do this now. Okay, so we spent maybe 25 minutes, half hour. Now, if you see over here, let me pull out right here. This is, again, original paint, and this is the new the freshly painted 10 years ago paint. So what I did here is I first started out with the Rupes and a Meguiar's microfiber cutting pad, and I didn't use the extra cut, just be clear of that, because we'll talk about that in a second. So I used that, put on here, and it really didn't show any difference, meaning nothing was coming off. It still looked like this. A little bit cleaner, but nothing, not enough for me to give it to a customer. So I said, okay, let's bump it up. Let's go with a stronger compound. And I went with leveling fluid, and it was pretty good, not great. I wanted to go more and more and more, because just sitting there with levelers compound and the microfiber cutting pad, you could do it again, but it's like with the spoon, it would just take me forever. So I said, let's not, go through a lot of time. Plus you're adding lots of heat at the same time. So you don't wanna do that. On this, what I did was I first started out with 3000 grit, Meguiar's Unigrit. the foam finishing disc, 3000 with a backing plate just to be soft, and I put it on the Roops, believe it or not. So this acts as a polisher when I don't have pneumatic with me. Then that worked okay, but not great. So then I bumped down. So remember, see how I'm going least aggressive to more aggressive? Then I went to 1500, and 1500 got all this gunk out. Now the trick to this whole process is two things. One, I have to have my paint depth gauge because I am taking off lots of, almost two, a little less than 2 mils on this. It has 8 mils, meaning it's been painted and there's a lot on there, unlike the 4 or 5 that are around the rest of the car. Hopefully you're keeping up with me here because it's getting confusing. So I'm checking every minute or two with the Positector to make sure I'm not taking too much off and burning through, because that would defeat the entire purpose. The second thing I'm doing is, if you can see here, is I'm using the pad washer. Like after maybe 4 or 5 passes, I'm using the pad washer, and the pad washer is disgusting. It's full of all this red. We're calling it blood because it's on the floor. It's all over me. It's on my shoes. It's just exploding everywhere because we're wet sanding. Wet sanding is getting, you know, getting water, and it's slinging everywhere. It's just totally normal. So enough talking. I know I get a lot of guys saying yak, yak, yak. Let me show you the exact process right here, and we'll make this side look like that side. But that was the steps that I went through to figure out the best way. So the best way, the final version, is I'm gonna use 1500 Unigrit, then I'm gonna go to 3000, so I'm wet sanding. Then I'm gonna go to the microfiber cutting disc with leveling fluid. It looks perfect, and once I get it all leveled out, then I'll go around the rest of the car, then after that, polish. So I'm giving you the quick version, so in case you get bored and wanna turn this off, you got most of it. So let's show you the steps right now. All right, so here are the steps to actually do it. Like we talked about, this is 1500 from Meguiar's Unigrit with a foam backing plate. The way that you prep these is not to dunk them in water. A lot of guys will use soap. Those days are long gone. You don't do that because of the technology in these pads. It'll actually throw off the cutting process. So what you do, I got my water, a few squirts, make that damp, and I'll just do this little area here, make it a little damp. That's it, and then you go to town, and I put it on usually speed 2.5, 3. You don't need to go too crazy. Light pressure. Light to medium pressure, slow movement, and you'll start to see this froth come out, and it's all red. That's normal. Now, again, I'm gonna just trying to do this little area for you on camera, but I'm going to rewash the car after this, so I'm not too worried about the sling. This car needs a lot of work, so multiple washes isn't abnormal. So see all this froth? Again, that's very typical. All right, so after the 1500, there is a pretty uniform, wet sanding mark right here. See, it's very gray, and this is shiny. So 1500, that looks normal to me. I need to do maybe this area a little bit. This little spot's always tough because it's concave, so I should probably go down to a smaller machine. But if you manipulate the pad enough, you can get in there. But this looks great. Up here's a little tough, so I gotta do this again. And then afterwards, we're gonna do 3000 and then polish that with a microfiber cutting pad. And we'll do this all in this little area right here. So you guys can definitely do this. It's very doable, especially on single stage paints. Next, I remove the 1500, put 3000 on. Make sure it's centered. You need to take your water, just like you did before. Light mist, you're good to go. Now you're going to take the 1500 out with the 3000. Again, froth is still gonna be there. Compound it out. All All right, before we hop on and talk about the trim, I wanted to tell you the last step, or I guess we can call it the second to last step. You can see the car's really starting to pop out here. I used a foam finishing pad, again, from Meguiar's, and I used my jeweler's polish, and the paint really pops. It looks pretty good, so I'm excited. I'm also drained. It was a couple of hours doing that. So now, let me show you what I do when I'm done with all this. I like to clean up the trim afterwards and kind of go after it. I did a little bit with the power washer, which was great at the very beginning of the day, but now I want to get in there with some all-purpose cleaner, and I'll show you some tools. It's not that big of a deal. And then what I put on there afterwards, that will create tons of contrast, especially against red versus black. So that should be kind of fun. All right, so the rest of the car is looking good. That's all I need to do is wax it, so that would be the last step. But now I'm gonna play with the trim. And typically I'll play with the trim at the beginning, while I'm washing, while I'm cleaning, while I'm claying. But this one was so bad that I kind of wanted to focus on it towards the end. So I have my two tools that I use all the time. One's a toothbrush, and it's got a double-ended side there. Another one is a very stiff bristled brush. And what I'll do is I'll use all-purpose cleaner and just really kind of soak it in there and let it do its thing for a little bit. Let it drip on the ground, get in all these fins. And while it's dripping, I'll go in there with my brush. And you really want to get in there and kind of gouge everything and kind of scrape it up a little bit so that it's you can remove a lot of the gunk. All right, guys, well, we finished up and it looks pretty spectacular. I spent, I want to say, maybe 9 hours or so on this car. It looks pretty good. Remember, this was very, very rough. Now let's do a quick recap. As you can tell, I used a lot of pads. These are cutting pads, and I have some finishing pads. Here's one. And it worked out nicely. But if I had stayed with the same technique, meaning using a cutting pad and just regular compound, I would not have had the same success on this panel because it was single stage, just like the rest of the car, but it had been painted previously. And the reason, or how I found that out, is I measured it and I could see there was way more paint, and it certainly looked different and was degrading faster or different than the rest of the car. So it made sense to me. So having said that, like I always say, there's no cookie cutter here. You have to let the paint tell you what it needs. So the big theme of the day is, can you polish / compound by hand on single stage? If the answer is yes, do I recommend you doing that? Not particularly, especially if you have tools or means to obtain tools, you should do that. Again, it's like digging a hole with a spoon versus a backhoe. But it came out pretty good. You have to take your time. Now on the trim, we're gonna do a whole trim video, but I just wanna give an idea. You have to protect these. This is very soft, porous plastic and trim here. And if you're compounding, it gets stuck in here. It's a pain in the butt to get out. So what I did, and I showed you on this side, I use all-purpose cleaner, AP cleaner, along with little brushes, stiff bristle brushes, and you want to get in there and kind of get everything out, dry it down, and then I use Black Wow, my buddy Richard Lynn's product, a really great product, and I got that from Detailer's Domain. Phil, a lot of you guys know Phil, good people. So yeah, if you have any questions, shoot me an email at larry@ammonyc.com. As always, thanks for watching. We'll see you guys next week. Check out all this red gunk. Ooh.